to the Project Narrative module. The Project Narrative contains all the central parts of your proposal. In Section 2A, we will go over the first three parts that relate to the Project Narrative form. These include the abstract, qualifications, and collaboration. The State Council requires particular pieces of information in the body of the Project Narrative. There is also a required project narrative form that you must complete as part of your application. It may be helpful to have the project narrative form with you as we go through this module. Before we get into the details of what content you need to include in your project narrative, let's review what you should pay attention to as you write it. The RFP guidelines outline the specific information that the State Council wants you to include in your proposal. You will need to use this information to answer the five questions on the project narrative form. Each regional office has its own specific goals and objectives from the State Council five-year plan that they want proposals to address. Your proposal must demonstrate clearly that it addresses a goal and objective identified in the Regional Office RFP and describes the steps you will take to achieve that objective. The RFP has specific instructions for the format of the project narrative that you must follow. You should use Arial font 14 point, 1-inch page margins, and you are only allowed a maximum of 10 pages of text. There are five required parts of the project narrative. They include the abstract, qualifications, collaboration, methodology, and outcome measures and evaluation. In this module, we will be discussing the first four parts of the project narrative. The information needed for the outcome measures and evaluation is covered in Module 3. We will begin with the abstract. The purpose of the abstract is to provide a brief summary of what is in the proposal. The abstract is important because it tells the grant reviewer right away what the proposal is all about. The State Council limits the abstract to one paragraph. Remember in writing your abstract that it counts towards your 10-page limit. Your abstract should identify your organization and important collaborators, as well as summarize the issue, problem, or need for your project. The abstract should also include the goal of your project and major activities and deliverables, as well as the impact your project will have on people with intellectual and developmental disabilities. The abstract should only include information that is in the proposal. You should not include any new information here. Although the abstract is the first item read by the reviewers, it should be the last section that you write because it is, in essence, a project summary. The qualifications for your organization should include an overview of your organization and its mission, who you serve, your experience working with people with developmental disabilities, your staff expertise, programs, and activities. Describing the qualifications of your organization is like writing a resume. It is a concise overview of your organization that establishes its credibility and its capability to carry out the project. It should include its history, including when it was founded, its purpose, programs, who and how many people are served. If possible, provide an example of activities you do with individuals with developmental disabilities. You want to emphasize activities that demonstrate you are qualified for carrying out the activities in your project. For example, if you are going to provide safety training to police officers when working with people with developmental disabilities, you would want to describe your experience doing this activity and the expertise of your staff for doing this kind of training. In your proposal, you will also identify the names of your collaborators and describe their specific role and responsibilities in your project. Just as you talk about your organization's qualifications, you should describe your collaborators' expertise, technical skills, or resources they bring to the project, and how this expertise fits within the project's plan goal, objective, and activities. All collaborators are required to submit a letter of support with original signatures. Their letters should include their specific role and responsibilities in the project. This is discussed more in Module 5. Let's go through an example. If your project aims to provide training to Latino families on self-determination, you might partner with an organization that serves this community. Their role may be to facilitate communication with the Latino community by interpreting and translating materials, and also with outreach. The next section will go into the methodology part of the project narrative.